Welcome to our third video in the Changing Accounting Systems series. This video, we will show exactly how to set up receivables and payables. This means we will show you exactly what to do and exactly how to do it. In the previous lesson, we discussed how we must enter the individual receivables and payables transactions before we make our main journal entry, and the results of those receivable and payable transactions must make the balance that we need it to be in the trial balance as of the day we transfer over the accounting systems. So what exactly do you enter? Well, the target is to make the open invoice report look exactly correct for each individual invoice's balance. So, the way to do that is to record the currently relevant transactions. And as we discussed, we enter the invoices, the payments, and the credits, all of which that relate to only the transactions that are listed here on the open invoice report. And if we enter them correctly, the ending balance of each individual invoice should match the report from the older system. Now, the exact steps tell you that you must put the original amount of each invoice that is open as of the transfer date. Now, that's a very good idea because you want to be able to see for any open invoice exactly what was purchased, exactly when it was purchased, and all the details on that invoice. So it is proper to enter the entire invoice as it was originally if the invoice is still open. And of course, we know we're going to enter any payments that have been applied to those invoices. And when you finish, the open invoice report must look exactly as it did in the old file. But here's the question. Should we enter the full amount of the payments or only the amount of the payment that's been applied to the currently open invoice? In other words, if we're entering the entire invoice of all the open invoices, why don't we enter the entire payment of all the payments that have been applied to those invoices? Well, let's think through an example for a moment. Let's imagine we have an open invoice report that has only one invoice on it. And let's imagine the invoice was $700, but now is only $500. That's because there was a $200 payment applied to that invoice. And that's why that's the only invoice on the open invoice report here at the end of the usage of the old system. And that's what we have to put in the new system. Now, it was check number 61 that came from a customer that gave us the $200 that was applied to that invoice. And I can assure you, if that was the only check, or if that was the only invoice that check was applied to, then it would make sense to just enter the invoice and the full amount, enter the $200 check, and then your open invoice report looks perfect, and the balance would be $500. However, check number 61 from the customer was actually $1,000. Now, the open invoice report is supposed to look like this. One invoice for $500 and total accounts receivable $500. But if you enter the full amount of check number 61, the open invoice report will instead look like this. You have the invoice open for $500, and then you have the other $800 just floating here on the open invoice report. And it's there on the open invoice report because there's no place to apply it. And there's no place to apply it because the other $800 from check 61 was applied to another invoice that is already closed. And we do not enter closed invoices in the new system, only the ones that are open at the moment we're switching over. So what does that mean? Well, it means that there was an extra $800 that we don't know what to do with if we enter the full amount of check 61. Now, I know what many of you are thinking, and you can read it right here in the top banner. Should we then enter any of the closed or paid off invoices for the remainder of the check to be applied to? Well, let's think that through a minute for a moment. Okay, let's just think. If we entered the invoice that the other $800 of check 61 is applied to, let's imagine that that $800 paid invoice number 7. And we know that invoice number 7 was paid in full. That's why we didn't want it on the open invoice report. So we say, okay, we'll enter the full amount of check 61, and then we'll take the other 800 and apply it to number 7 by entering invoice number 7. Well, I have some bad news. Invoice number 7 was actually $2,000. Only $800 of the $2,000 was applied from check 61. The other $1,200 was paid from another check that came from the customer, check number 76. So should we enter check number 76? Well, that $1,200 was applied from check number 76 that helped pay off the full amount of invoice number 7. But the problem is, check number 76 was actually $3,000. And you see, the other $1,800 of check 76 was applied to another invoice that was already paid off, and so on. So I think you get the point. The point is that we follow a rule which declares for each open invoice, enter only the payment amount that has been applied to an open invoice and not necessarily the full amount of the payment. That would avoid the paradox and the loop that we were just stuck in a moment ago. Now, why is this rule acceptable? Well, past payments have already been reconciled in the older system, so you don't have to worry about having a problem with your bank or not matching the bank, because the last month of the old system is going to be reconciled and those checks would be a part of it. Now, you should also consider that if those checks that we talked about are going to be part of the new system, then you don't have to worry, because the main setup journal entry that we are going to make will automatically account for the differences in the cash account for the amount of the checks that were applied to the closed invoices. So we don't have to worry. It's already taken to consideration mathematically. Just enter those checks or those payments from customers only in the amount that decreased the invoice and not the full amount if some of that amount has been applied to an invoice that's already closed. Believe me, if you do it this way, your bank reconciliation will work on the very first month of the new system. So, exactly how do we find the payments that have been applied to only the open invoices? Well, each invoice has its own payment history. And all you have to do is open up the invoice to see the full amount of the invoice so that you can re-enter it in the new system. And then you can look at the invoice payment history to see the specific payments and the specific amount of those payments that have been applied to those open invoices. In most very good software, like QuickBooks Desktop, you can find out all the information you need to input right here from the open invoice report. For example, this first one with Alan on top, you can double-click this $2,900 open invoice and see that it was actually a $3,900 invoice originally, when the window was not stretched open as much. But you can see it was $3,900 and payments applied were $1,000. Even better, you can click Reports in the ribbon and then click Transaction History, and you can actually see a list of every payment that had been applied to this particular invoice. And you can select that payment and click Go To. Remember, it's very important that you click Go To and actually see the payment to make sure that the payment was not applied to any of the invoices that were already closed. The same idea applies to QuickBooks Online. Here's the open invoice report, or let's say the equivalent open invoice report in QuickBooks Online. This is the very same invoice. If you double-click right on the face of the report, you get to the invoice. Just getting to the invoice is helpful because you have to physically re-enter this invoice in the new system in the full amount because it is still opened on the date of transfer. But look in QuickBooks Online how easy it is to see all the payments that have ever been applied to the invoice you're looking for. Now remember, it's not enough just to see it as the amount. You have to click on it and actually keep clicking until you go to the payment. Because again, you have to reopen the payment window to make sure that part of the payment was not applied to a closed invoice. So that's the way you can make your list of payments to enter, and that's the way you can find out all the information about the invoices that are still open. And you have to enter all of them one by one. There might be special software, or you might just pay someone who works very quickly to do data entry. But once these are in, your accounts receivable and your accounts payable setup is all finished. Thank you.